antique. This is my wedding dress. I have a right to see it if I want to.
Sorel still alone?
Not anymore.
Who's with him?
Rick and Carlos, they just arrived.
I trusted Rick with Carly's safety.
Sonny, there's no way you could have...
I promised her that night I took her and Michael out of the court of Maine that I would always protect her.
How do you want him?
He has to pay.
Just give me the word.
You haven't. You sure it's just Sorel, Carlos, Rick in the office and no guards posted?
None of Sorel's men are around.
He probably thinks he drove us in the ground after the fire.
It's good that he's overconfident.
You know how many times I put Michael into Rick's arms, told Carter to stick close to him? What if he kidnapped him or killed him?
Why did you call and tell me about the fire?
It was late and there was nothing that you could have done.
Oh, you must have been terrified.
I don't really want to talk about it, okay?
So, what are we doing here? Why are you closing the door?
Because I need your help. We don't have a lot of time. Sonny could be back at any minute.
Oh, okay. What do you need my help with?
See that dress bag over there?
Yeah, about it.
Uh-huh. Sonny bought my wedding gown.
You're kidding.
No, he wants to surprise me. I'm not supposed to look at it till the day of the wedding.
Isn't it usually the groom that's not supposed to see the dress?
Yeah, the man wants to do something special for me, so that's why I need your help.
Oh, okay. All right, what do you need my help with?
Okay, here's the thing. Sonny is sort of really insistent that I don't see the dress before the day, and I promised him that I wouldn't. I don't want to upset him. I don't want to break that promise, but... I'm sort of having second thoughts, Mom. What if it's awful? What if it's frilly and over the top, or it's got sleeves up to here? Worse yet, a collar that buttons up at the neck. You know how conservative he is.
Yeah, right. So what do you need me to do?
I thought I wouldn't be breaking my promise if you looked at the dress, and then you told me what to expect.
Oh! Well, sure.
Okay.
Okay, turn around.
Okay. What do I do? And what do I do if I hate it?
Oh, don't worry. We'll figure something out.
Well?
Oh, I don't believe it.
It's the worst, right?
No, it's perfect.
Carly worries about me being safe all the time. She was in danger because I put it there.
And now you're taking care of it.
I put the people close to me, open to attack, that can never happen.
There's no way that you could have known.
Like I couldn't have known there was a bomb in the car. Carly's with that bastard because of me. My life, my choices. You remind me whenever I say to you, hey, there's nothing to worry about. Everybody's fine. You remind me of this day.
I don't want to get married in 40 yards of pink tulle, like, looking like Glenda the Good from the Land of Oz.
Oh, stop. No, the dress that Sonny shows is, it's elegant. It's understated.
Oh, it's one of those Puritan numbers, right? It has buttons all the way up to the top. I knew it. See, he doesn't want the breeze to, like, look at my cleavage.
Carly, you're working yourself up into a state over nothing.
Okay, well, at least just, well, okay, what color am I getting married in?
It's white.
Is it white with lace or white with beads or what?
My lips are sealed.
I know it. It's like one of those ice capade things, right? It's cut off at the knee and it sort of frills out on the sides.
Oh, now stop, stop. You just finished telling me what wonderful taste Sonny has.
What are you doing?
I'm helping you keep your promise. Where did it go?
In the closet behind the tuxedos.
Trust me, this dress is to die for.
Really?
Surprise.
Get their weapons, Johnny.
I know you were back in town, Morgan.
Get your hands off me. He's clean.
You got here just in time.
Shut the hell up.
Don't be stupid, Sorel.
You're gonna regret this.
Not likely. We have unfinished business.
What do you think you're doing?
What I should have done a long time ago. Hello, Rick. How you doing?
This is Quintos.
I come looking for my enemy, and I find my wife's personal bodyguard. What do you think I should do about that?
Sonny gave those to me for Valentine's.
These are gorgeous.
Yeah.
Oh.
He said there was no way he was going to let me get married in earrings Jason gave me. At least not this time when it counts.
Well, I think it was a good thing that Jason was around last night. You know, it was all over the news, the way he saved Sonny from the fire.
I don't know. I haven't turned on the news. I haven't picked up a newspaper.
Why not? Blocking it out?
No, I don't think that Michael needs to see Jason and Sonny on the news, and neither do I.
This must be really difficult for you.
Mom, listen, okay? I'm trying to share with you what is going to be the most incredible day of my life. Let's not make it about what my husband does for a living, okay?
You've been an inconvenience for a long time.
We've had our misunderstandings, but it's not too late to forge an alliance.
You've hurt people I care about.
Communications have broken.
Shut up!
You hired a sniper to kill me and my wife while we were walking around. Now, he missed because you never hired the best, but he could have hit her. She was in danger. She was upset.
I have a great respect for you.
I thought I asked you to be quiet. You've been out of control since you killed Marino. I stood by, gave you the time to mismanage his territory, which you have done. I didn't feel the need to provoke you because I figured your own people would handle the situation. And what do I get for my trouble for giving you some room? You kidnapped my wife's mother. You used my father's weakest point against me. And at Christmas time, you hire a hit on me. You don't mind taking out a woman, a teenage boy, and Jason Morgan's little sister. You firebomb my warehouse and you interfere with my people. Carlos, Rick, who I paid to protect my wife and my family. Now, you've done all these things. Now it's time to pay.
If I may speak.
Why should I let you?
Because you're a fair man. An honorable man.
Go ahead.
I deeply regret any pain that I've caused you or your family. But if we had come to an agreement regarding Xander Smith, we
should have taken him out that night. Your people killed that undercover cop.
I made a mistake.
Mm-hmm.
I only wanted to make it right. If you had delivered Xander Smith to me, none of this would have...
You're not smart enough for this line of work. Mr. Sorel, enjoy your boat ride. Johnny, you know what to do.
Do what you're gonna do, Corinthos.
Carlos. My right-hand man from Puerto Rico.
¿Cómo estamos, amigo?
Bien, todo va bien.
¿Y la familia?
Todos bien.
Uh-huh.
We worked together a long time, sir.
Yeah. I let you run that territory as you saw fit. Gave you a chance to expand your experience, to move up. And this is how you show me appreciation, by creating one crisis after another? By forcing me to waste Jason's time to keep an eye on you? By keeping me away from my family at Christmas?
I'm sorry, sir.
Carlos, listen to me! Did you really believe you could take anything from me?
Mr. Grintos, escúchame, te digo la verdad.
Mm-hmm. Get him.
Rick.
One of my own. Now it's time to reward your loyalty.
Sorel's garbage, Carlos. His business. But you, I allowed into my home.
I told Carly to stay close, not to give you the slip. I trusted you, Rick, to drive her wherever she needed to go, to watch over her. I told Michael to mind you, to stay close where he could see you. You buckled him into his car seat. You took him by the hand and you led him into his classroom. I trusted you with my heart. Then I see you from a rooftop taking money. Oh, you... taking money from Joseph Sorel. Then it all came together. The night of the hit, you were supposed to bring the car around. I couldn't. Couldn't find it. We walked into the line of fire. Me, Alexis Davis, Xander Smith, Jason's little sister, we're all because of you.
I didn't know that was gonna happen.
Now you're lying to me! Don't lie anymore!
Mr. Quintos, I never knew.
Don't you talk right now. I trusted you with my family.
I could have killed Carly at any time, but I never did!
It's all right.
I want him awake. He needs to understand what he's done. Make him an example. He needs to show people what it costs to betray me. Go.
Carly. Hey.
Hey. Right here.
Oh. Where were you? Huh?
I was in the kitchen. Everything's fine, though. Don't panic. Except that I thought that you could heat up frozen pizza under the broiler, but turns out you can't. That'd be the point where you'd probably start yelling at me.
You're not wearing your earrings.
I didn't want to, drop one of them in the drain.
But if you'd stayed out of the kitchen, you know that wouldn't happen.
Those earrings are for our wedding.
Put them on.
Yeah? Okay. You do?
Yeah.
So what?
Come
You okay?
I'm fine. Sorel's been taken care of. He's not gonna bother anybody again.
Is Jason okay?
Yeah.
He came back just at the right time, didn't he?
That's right.
Honey? When we get to Martini, can we just forget that any of this ever happened, and I just want to spend the whole day thinking about my wedding, and about my dress, and about my life with you. My mother came by today. We didn't fight. That was good. I can do this, you know? You know that, right? I mean, I can. I can live this life.
You did good.
And everything worked out, just like you said. I got through it. You kept me safe, and you came home, and...
You will never be hurt because of me.